We are very excited. There's a lot of appetite for life extension for dogs and also for improving the health of all dogs.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Genflow Biosciences CEO, Dr. Eric Leire. Eric, happy new year to you. You've put out a review in which you described 2024 as an incredible year for Genflow. Take us through some of the highlights of the year.
Okay, thank you, Stefan. It's quite important for us to explain what we're doing and to give an update. For an investor, you know, the process is quite long in biotech. It's a very regulated industry, and people may think, hey, what are they doing, with, especially with my money? So it's I thank you to give me the opportunity to explain what we're doing. I will focus mostly on four projects, four programs that will be our priorities for 25. One will be the MASH project, the liver disease. The second will be sarcopenia. The third one will be the dog project. And I will end up also with the project on mitochondria. Okay, let's start then with the MASH project. The MASH project is now, we are finalizing the preclinical program. We are at the pre-IND phase of that program. The objective of the preclinical is to have the authorization to start a clinical trial in human. To do that, we need to demonstrate efficacy. We need to demonstrate that we understand the mechanism of action. And the bottleneck is we need to provide to the patient that will be in the study the same exact product that will be commercialized in 5, 6, 7 years, if everything goes according to the plan. This is a big bottleneck. It's very expensive. It's one of those things where you're not supposed to make errors, because errors will be very costly. We like usually to say, oh, it's great to make mistakes, you learn from your mistakes, but in that case, it's too expensive. So we need to prepare that very carefully, and we need to have the possibility to do large-scale manufacturing according good manufacturing practice. It's a lot of work. It's not sexy for the investor. It's super important for us. We chose our partner very carefully. We put several manufacturers for us in competition. We selected two. We finalized with one. We did a first test to see at medium level, not really the upscaling, if that was okay, if the yield was okay, and we're quite satisfied. So we're embarking now in this. There's no shortcut. It will take time. You need to do three batches. The three batches have to be consistent. We need to demonstrate that we can characterize the product properly. Once we've done that, we can go back to the healthcare authorities and ask for a CTA, clinical trial authorization. And that's when we start to try the product in human, demonstrate that it has efficacy. And that's when you have the trigger to unlock valuation and to really get a huge upside in terms of share price. That's the first project. The second project I mentioned was sarcopenia. Sarcopenia is quite important for us because the muscles, sarcopenia is a loss of muscles when you age. The loss of muscles is unfortunately a very bad news. But it's also important because, so clinically, it's very relevant for the patient. It's also important for us because the mechanism of action here is the mitochondria. Mitochondria is a small organelle in the cell that's responsible for the energy. That's what the fuel of the cells. And we lose mitochondria as we age. So what we do here is restore the function of mitochondria. So not only it will be useful for the muscle per se, but it will be also very interesting because we will understand the effect on the mitochondria, and that could have impact on the brain, had to impact on the immune system. As soon as you restore a high level of energy, you can improve a lot of functions in the body. So very excited, this project. We conduct this project in collaboration with Revatis. We are progressing according to the plan. We're very happy with that. We still have the Werner syndrome. The Werner, we made some progress also. The typical way to develop a product in preclinical is to prove the efficacy in animals. And we have animals models that are supposed to mimic what will be the efficacy in human. Some of those models are very relevant. If it works in monkey, it will work perfectly well in human. If it works sometime in mice, it will work. In the case of Werner, unfortunately, if it works in mice or if it doesn't work in mice, it's not at all representative of what will happen in human. The any animal models is very weak and give you false negative or false positive. So what we've done to turn that difficulty is to develop synthetic organs, organoids, based, we took cells of patients, of human patients. We asked for their permission to use that for research. And we took three patients with Werner. We borrowed some of cells. We culture, we reverse those into stem cells. And from those stem cells, we re-differentiate those stem cells into liver, and we built a synthetic liver. We have done that successfully. It's a lot of work. We have tested that not only this liver can be, we can deliver the product to that liver. When I say it's a synthetic liver, it's almost a liver, but the vascularization is not the same. You don't have the same blood supply. So it was very important to see if we could reach the cells, if we could deliver the gene. Now we know that it's possible, and we will start to test the drug to see if there's an efficacy in this model. That will be also the trigger for us to go for the manufacturing again and ask for clinical trial authorization in Werner under an orphan drug designation status. That will allow to speed up the process. It's a fast track that allow for rare disease like Werner syndrome to go faster than the usual track. Finally, the fourth project is the dog project. I know you like dogs, so, and a lot of our shareholders love dogs. We are starting with a totally different approach. Biotech, because everything is expensive, and we are a little bit of control freak. We like to control everything. Here we want to go fast, and we want to go directly to the acid test. Is it working? Yes or no? And we've been able to do that. We will test in 25 dogs, 8 dogs. It was difficult to find 8 dogs. There's a lot of CROs, contract research organization, that provide young dogs, but CROs are willing to breed dogs until they are 10 years old and then offer them for the test. There's not that many. We found one with Xinjiang. We are ready to start the trial. We have 3 months of paperwork going through the license importation so we can send our product to Morocco where the study will be conducted. We need to go through the ethical committee to be sure that the dog are treated well. And we will start, it's a 6 months treatment followed by 6 months analysis. This means that by end of maybe less than 6 months, but Q1 26 or end of 25, we should be able to have a yes or no. It's working or not. If it's yes, we get a deal with a pharma specializing in vet. Fantastic. If it's no, that doesn't mean it's the end of the program. That means we need to analyze the data, understand where are the problems, try to see, fix the problems, try again. If we cannot fix, won't work. But we are very excited. There's a lot of appetite for life extension for dogs and also for improving the health of all dogs. We all have dogs and we get more and more attached. Mine is 8 years old. She's nice. She's still healthy. She can still run and jump. And very soon it will be a little bit different. And it's heartbreaking to see your dogs going, you know. We have a potential solution, so we are very excited about that. Those will be our priorities for 25.
Eric, it sounds like you have a very, very busy year ahead for you. I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress you make.
Thank you so much, again, to give me this opportunity. And I will take the opportunity also to wish Happy New Year's to all the shareholders that have been patient with us with our progress and still supporting the company. Happy New Year's to all.
That's Dr. Eric Leire. He's the CEO of Genflow Biosciences.